give Nitin Bhai Mehta to give introduction of Venkatraman sir. Sir, we welcome you here. what words I should say, because after long 1.5 years waiting, we are able to hear you. And now I request Nitin Mehta, CA Nitin Mehta, to give introduction of sir.
Dignitaries on and off the rise, my learned friends. In fact, the introduction what Bhishan has given is the time and the dates which we were trying to get of his to bring him here has taken us almost 1 year long, which itself shows how sought after and busy does he remain. And at the same time, knowing him personally, I can assure the house that as much we want him, he also wants to be here, but for his schedule and availability of dates. Now, he has worked under one of the great advocates in tax law is Mr. C. Natarajan, senior advocate between May 1989 and June 2003. Prior to February 2006, he has briefed former Attorney General, Solicitor General, Additional Solicitor General and other high profile senior counsels in various tax matters. He himself was designated as a senior advocate in February 2006 at a very, very young age at 40. We few advocates who are present know very well that to be designated at the age of 40 as a senior advocate is in fact an achievement. And that was designated because of the recommendation by none other but Mr. Harish Salve and Mr. Joseph Velapalli. Those who do not know the second name, he is one of the most sought after counsels in tax matters in South, back in South. He has appeared so far before 20 high courts across the country and the Honorable Supreme Court of India, besides various tax tribunals, Settlement Commission, Authority for Advance Ruling and Central Appellate Mechanism. Appearing on various constitutional issues relating to taxation and leading matters in the field of international taxation, transfer pricing, service tax and VAT. Was the first counsel for ENY between 2005 and 2009. And is now being engaged by all multinational chartered accountant firms, besides being law firms like us who also engage him. Some of the decisions have been adjudicated as the best case of the respective year by the International Tax Forum. Renders advice and assistance on transfer pricing issues, international taxation, matters relating to GAR and SAR at a global level, has been part of various special benches rendering assistance to rule on important transfer pricing and taxation issues, is offering advice and assistance in various regulatory matters and commercial disputes. He has shifted his base from originally Chennai to New Delhi because his clients wanted him to stay 20 days, which are the 20 working days in a month in Delhi. And therefore, he thought it fit to have a base back in Delhi and is appearing before the Honorable Supreme Court, Delhi High Court and various other tribunals. The only passion other than work is nurturing and propagating Vedas and Vedic philosophy. This was something which I noted and was speaking about. But two very distinctive facts which I would want to bring to the notice of this house, that having briefed myself so many counsels, there is no counsel today in entire India who can be effective both in direct tax and indirect tax. And Even in indirect tax, as we know, we have divisions between central taxes and state taxes, which are VAT, and central being excises, service tax, and it would be difficult for one to judge, and no one would be able to judge in which he is better. Lastly, I would only say that if there is any point or any question or any problem which others are unable to solve, there is no other option but to refer to him. And by this, I call upon, probably that's all what I can say. Otherwise, the entire session will be less. Thank you.
Thank you, Nitin, for giving his sir's introduction. I request Jigar Bhai, before sir starts, to give a bouquet and a memento as a love and affection. Sir, with this series we have started, I request you to inaugurate with knowledge of your knowledge and enlighten our mind and thought process with your great knowledge. Thank you, sir. Thank
you. Dear Bhushan Bhai, Nitin, and my dear well wishers. I feel so humble and I feel so guilty that there has been an extraordinary delay in reaching this place. Completely attributable to my fault. The kind of chase Vishen should have done. I think he has the greatest tolerance. Needs to be rewarded for that. I'm so sorry, but I'll try to make it up in the next 1 hour. I assure you that. See, let's get into the topic straight away. When you have a book or a computer and you want to sell it to somebody, then there is a buyer, there is a seller, there is a property, there is a transfer, and there is a consideration. So, when you have all these factors put together in a transaction, the transaction is called in ordinary terms as a transaction of sale. Now, you do the same transaction but in a different way and mask it with any one of these operating limbs to be deficient. Then what happens to such a transaction? For example, the same computer, instead of selling it to you, say for 25,000 rupees, I rent it to you. Give me 1,000 rupees a month for next 2 years. There is a person who owns it. There is a person who is going to use it. There is a transfer. There is also a consideration, but there is no transfer of a title. So how do you deal that transaction in law? That's one instance. Right. Let's take the same building. This building can be built in any one of the three ways. What are the ways? I'm the owner. The contractor can sell the brick, the cement, and the steel to me for a price. Then I hand over this property to him and ask him to erect this building. Then it's called a divisible contract of sale of goods followed by a service. This is one way. The second way, I tell him, you don't trouble me, sir. I am least bothered about how much kilos of cement you are going to use, how much tons of steel you are going to use. You better build this and give it to me. And I will pay you a check for that. And I will pay you milestone. 25% at this stage, 50% at this stage. So he takes the care of bringing all the property to the site. Then he transfers it into a building, transforms it into a building, and hands over the building to you. Where it is an indivisible contract of both sale and service. Second way. Now the third way. I doubt the credentials of the contractor. I don't want him to make margins on material. So I tell him, look here, I will buy cement, steel and bricks. I'll give it to you. You just put your sweat and construct this building and give it to you. In all these three transactions, the same building emerges. Same building comes with the same dimensions. No change. But the tax implications are not the same. So this is the second scenario. Now let's take the third. We love food. Now, your wife says, get lost, I can't cook for the day. The reversal is also possible. More possible. So, what happens? You go to the restaurant and order some food. He packets and then delivers you the food. You carry the food and come home and try to please your wife for the day. Now, this is the sale of roti or sale of chapati or idli, as the case may be, for a price. So, like a computer, there is a seller, there is a buyer, and idli transfers for a price. Fortunately, idlis are not leased. It is only sold. We have not reached that era. It is only sold. So, you buy the idlis and go home. And please your wife. This is one way. You want to please her better. So you say, please get ready. I'll come and pick you. And as usual, you are 24 hours late. You pick her the next day evening. And take her to your restaurant. And then both of you dine. Spend happily 3.5 hours without much of fighting. And because you discuss about environmental issues, about how government should be run, so no conflicts. When recently two people got engaged and they are going to get married after 1 year, the elders, as a part of their wish, said, you can meet frequently, you can spend your time happily, but never talk about yourself or your families. Talk about generally for 1 year so that you don't pick up a fight. So, you spend 3 hours together, happily, very, very happily. And he gets you, slaps a bill on you for 3,000 rupees for that happiness. And he wants to charge you a tax. Now, what sort of a tax can he charge up? Correct? So, these are the three situations which we need to deal. In all these situations, there is a transfer of property. Goods are changing hands and consideration is passing. So, prior to the 46th Amendment, before they brought what is called Article 366-29 Capital A, these three transactions could not be taxed at all. The reason they gave was the Madras High Court in ABM Studios said, leasing of a film does not amount to a sale in its conventional sense. Because in lease, only there is a transfer of right to use. There is no transfer of ownership. So, you can't tax a lease transaction. That's the judgment by the Madras High Court. When it came to the building, the constitutional bench in First Canon Dunkerley said, if you sell bricks, cement and mortar separately, followed by a service contract, cement, steel for say 50 lakh rupees and service for 25 lakh rupees, you are entitled to tax on 50 lakhs sales tax and leave 25 lakhs from the purview of sales tax. But on the other hand, if he's going to make a turnkey works contract at 75 lakhs and bill you after the building is constructed, you can't tax even 1 rupee, even though property is possible. It said that in a normal sale, it is not mere transfer. Transfer of the same goods identified. If I identify a computer, you can't transfer idli to me. So they said, in a cement steel transfer contract, cement, steel and mortar is getting transferred. We can understand. But in an indivisible contract, it is not, you can't be breaking the cement steel. It all becomes a conglomerate as an immovable property. What they call it, principle of accretion. In a sale, the transfer takes place by passing the title from A to B as chattel. That's the essence. What do you mean by as chattel? Computer transferred from A to B as computer. Apples transferred from B to C as apples. Whereas in a works contract scenario, cement, steel and mortar becomes a building and the building is getting transferred. So cement, steel and mortar gets into an accretion into a building. Accretion becomes the taxable point, and today you don't have a law which can impose a tax on accretion. So you can't tax indivisible contracts. When it came to food, three judgments of the Supreme Court said eating food in a restaurant, they made it very clear, vending of a food from a counter is the same, like selling apples. But going and enjoying the facility of a restaurant and eating food along with it is administering the bodily want. And therefore, the food which goes into the system to please you and your friends is actually part of a service, even though it has goods in it. Construe the whole transaction as a service transaction, and therefore you cannot impose a sales tax. So three things emerged: lease, no tax; indivisible works contract, no tax; food contract, no tax. Then the government thought, this is not going to do good to India, because everybody converted a sale transaction into a lease transaction. Everybody converted a simple supply contract into a complex works contract. And everybody escaped a levy on food by preferring to take his spouse to the hotel rather than taking the food to the house. So there was no tax. 46th Amendment brought six categories to sale. Rest of the three are this hire purchase and then this association and this statutory goods, statutory price. Not very, very important. Hire purchase and lease are almost the same. So let's not worry about that. So these three things were brought under the tax net. How did they do it? They said, even if you transfer goods for a right to use, then it is liable to a sale. The rental becomes the consideration for sale. Pay the tax. Even if you transfer the property as an indivisible works contract through accretion, it permitted every government to cut open this transaction into two through a pair of legal scissors. Cut the transaction, find the material portion, exclude the labor portion and tax the material portion. As say. And when it came to the food contract, because Supreme Court said The whole contract is a service including the food involved. It deemed the whole service contract as a sale contract. That's the point between works contract and a food contract. So in a food contract, the entire contract which was considered to be service was deemed to be a sale. In a works contract, the deeming fiction was only directed against the property and service was left out. Am I clear to you on this? This concept has to be understood very clearly before we progress to the next stage. So these are the two basic distinctions, because both in works contract and in food contract, property passes. So if food contract is also going to be a works contract, you don't have to have a separate taxation for food contract. It is also a form of works contract only. They didn't do it. They construed food contract in its entirety as only a sale contract. Clear? So these three things came within the ambit of taxation for states to generate better revenue. Now, what are the complications? How are we all prospering all these years? And how younger generation will continue to prosper? Is because disputes of these natures are now slowly appearing. What are the disputes? When it came to a leasing transaction, what is the dividing line between a transfer of a right to use and a right to use? This is the sharp contrast which we have been debating in the last 10 years. I would have stepped in and stepped out at least from 10 different high courts on this point. You have this issue both on tangibles and on intangibles. Both. I'll give you a typical example. What is the dividing line? Now, as I said, I have a computer worth 25,000 rupees. I want to recover 25,000 rupees from you. I let it on lease to you for a period of 25 months at 1,000 rupees per month. What does the transaction benefit, or what is the effect of the transaction? The effect of the transaction is my computer from my hands moves out to his hands. He becomes he has an exclusive possession over that property, a control over the property, and an authority to use the property the way he likes. He can switch it on, he can switch it off, he can use it, he can misuse it, he can do anything during the tenure of the lease. I have no control over it. So, I have delivered the stuff. I have also passed the control to him. Delivery and control, if it goes into the hands of the lessee, then it becomes a deemed sale, liable to sales tax. On the contrary, all of you are using mobile, possibly two or three multiples, or two or three in the same mobile also, depending on the technology you use. Now, how do you capture these mobile signals? You need towers. If you understand from technology perspective, tower is nothing but equivalent to a human voice. One tower loves the other tower and starts communicating its own rhythm through a frequency. Otherwise, we can't get messages, nor can we send messages, either good, bad, frustrating, happy or sad. Multiple bouquet of messages. Psychological crisis comes most often because of WhatsApp. That's the fine thing. Create moments of happiness and deep moments of sorrow is because of WhatsApp. So, after all, we are seeing all this every day, day in and day out. Diverse cases happen. Why? Because surreptitiously, through a computer, the partner's WhatsApp is captured. And the man sits at the computer and starts watching what he is communicating or she is communicating with his or her friends and produces it before the court. So, technology has its own downside also. So, be careful. So, Now, how does it happen in a transfer of right use case? In a transfer of right use case, in all these cases of towers, the company which owns the tower has the responsibility to run the tower. Are they giving transfer right to use the tower to you? Do you know which tower is that you are accessing at what point of time? You have no knowledge. You enter into a contract with your service provider X, Y or Z and say, I need 24/7 uninterrupted supply of service. So, the telecommunication operator who is using the tower or tower company using the tower, it is his responsibility to deliver you the service using the tower. A tower is, now this is in terms of the customer, so subscriber base. Come to the operator. Because of the telecom policy, originally towers were owned by each company had its own tower. Now one, you hive off and make a tower company and make five people use it. You populate it with more tower to reduce pollution, reduce cost, etc., etc. When five people use the tower, there again, the tower company takes the responsibility of delivering service to the operator. I will deliver you the electricity at this temperature, at this altitude, at this frequency. I will ensure that your active infrastructure is placed at a proper level to capture the signal. All the rest, in fact, if you see those agreements, your efficiency has to be at 99.9%. And if it drops down five times in a month, the entire consideration for the month is not payable to you. It's so stiff. The quality levels are so stiff. Otherwise, how will the call drop? How is it happening? Right. So, in all these cases, courts have declared, even though there is a tower involved, the tower is not transferred to the subscriber or to the operator. The delivery and control of the tower does not get into the hands of the users. It remains with the man who provides the service. So, when delivery and control doesn't pass, even though an equipment is installed, an equipment is used, and a consideration is paid towards that equipment, you cannot call it as a team design. So, dividing line is very, very, very clear. Transfer, delivery, control, sales tax. No transfer, no delivery, no control, but usage of the machinery for consideration. Service tax. Okay, this is fine as far as tangible is concerned. What do you do with intangible? Recently, I argued it for 5 full days before the Bombay High Court. This is the point. Which is what you have raised in a question, somebody. Very interesting question. Very nice question, according to you. I own an IPR. Right? This IPR, I can give it on a lease basis in two ways. I can say, I will divest my right in my hand, give you the IPR for you to use it as yours for next 5 years. Technical know-how. I say, I will divest my right, transfer it to you for 5 years. After 5 years, it should come back to me. And I will charge you a rental every year, every month, at this many thousands or this many lakhs, depending upon the contract. This is one way where I lose my right over the IPR and hand it over to him temporarily for a period of 5 years. There is another way. I retain the IPR with me. I give him the license to use for 5 years. And I say that you are a non-exclusive licensee. I am entitled to give this license, the same right, to somebody else in different territory or in the same territory. It is my choice. So where the relationship is purely licensor and licensee and consideration is concerned. Now, how do you tax the consideration? After all, there is a difference between both the transactions which I narrated. In both the transactions, there is an IPR involved. But in the first transaction, you lose the right temporarily in your hands and it goes to him. You cannot transfer it one more time to anybody else. Okay? It's different from you holding the right in your hands and keep issuing it as a licensed right for any number of people over a period of 5 years and generate more and more money. Both in law cannot be the same. In one, right is lost temporarily. In the other, right is retained. Only the license to use or a right to use, not a transfer. In the first case, there is a transfer of a right. Whereas in the second case, there is only a right to use. So, which is liable to what tax? The first transaction is liable to sales tax. The second transaction is liable to service tax. But what happened in Bombay was, Tata and Sons was a judgment which said the second transaction is also liable to sales tax. Division tax. Now, I had a chance to argue the same point for a different assessee after a few months, after Tata Sons got delivered. And before the same court, the senior judge who has authored the judgment. So we brought this distinction to the court, saying that you have construed the second transaction also as a sale in the deal. Whereas in a transfer of right scenario, the right must be transferred. I must be divested of the right at that given point of time. I should not be the owner of the right anymore. Temporary loss of the right. There must be a temporary loss of right. Whereas in a licensed scenario, there is no temporary loss. Because I can keep on giving this license to any number of people. So don't call this as a transfer of right to use. We showed a lot of judgments. Historically, we captured a lot of things have been debated. Judgment is reserved. But I must share a very interesting professional experience I had. What happens? In about 1.5 hours, we were able to persuade the court that the earlier view is not correct, taken by the court. The judge was also very fair. But ultimately, a judge-made law, especially the very same judge who has authored the judgment, to confront him to say that you have to change your judgment. It's a very serious challenge. So what did we do? We sat and researched. Are there any judgments in the past where the same judge has overturned his own judgment? We always go by precedent. Always we go by precedent and practices. Law develops that way. Whatever you need to do, you can't be very revolutionary or evolutionary. You need to have a precedent. We located 8 classic judgments across the world. 8 classic judgments. I would say my best moments of my professional life I passed through when I did this matter and I was reading these judgments. I was experiencing professional bliss, not spiritual bliss, but professional bliss. Just a scintillating experience to read that matter. Starting from Lord Denning, who is always worshipped as the Bhishma Pitamaha of amongst judges, they have overturned their own judgments. We found out very interesting passages. Then American judge, Justice Jackson, all of them saying, yeah, I'm wrong last time. Why should I perpetuate the error the second time once I realize that I committed an error? See the fairness. And India is not far behind. Our Chief Justice, as he then was, Justice P.N. Bhagavati, has done this in Lohia Missions case. He said that, huh?
In
Gujarat. Oh, no, I think. should take the credit for that also. So, he has written a judgment saying that my conscience doesn't permit me to perpetuate the mistake I have committed in the earlier judgment. Now, all right, 8 judgments have been located. You have to put it in a pleasing way to your judge. The tact lies there. Huh? You can't simply say you are wrong. These judges have all said they are wrong. You also have to restate it. You can't tell the judge. So, I have to make one statement after citing these 8 judgments. I underwent a great spiritual experience. I am sharing this only for that reason. He was referring to my guru, Mr. C. Natarajan. How much it matters in a life, because Gujarat is known for guru worship, how much it matters in your life, your guru. I thought I should share this. Partly professional, partly spiritual. There are a lot of youngsters, so just to gain conviction about our ethos and our value systems. So, I have to make one statement to the court after citing these 8 judgments. I was struggling. All this preparation was possible because you, on a click of a button you are getting all this. One statement, it's not clicking. Start clicking. Previous day, next day is going to be over. All these judgments are ready. I reached the hotel. Sat for a while, nothing occurred. Closed the books. And I started to pray to my teacher who taught me for 14 years. Can you help me? Please guide me with an answer. Nothing stuck that day. Next day morning, nothing stuck. From 12 o'clock to 2 o'clock I argue. Nothing is occurring. Then court goes for lunch, resumes at 3. From 3 to 3:35 I argue. Nothing occurs. So I was about to close down after reading the 8th judgment. And I was struggling to make a statement to complete, should fulfill, should make. Okay, you cite, now what should I do? That's the question the judge will ask. All right, they've all done, so what should I do? As I completed the 8th judgment, a flash occurred. It's not human effort. I must say this. It's beyond human effort. A flash occurred. I told the court, let me complete this whole hearing of 5 days with this statement. If your lordships are convinced and persuaded that the judgment pronounced by you on the earlier occasion is incorrect, you are now standing on a moment of glory. You are just one step away from the moment of glory. You now have a unique golden opportunity to become heroes and the ninth, you become heroes and join this exclusive club of judges and judgments all over the world. You are just standing on the brink. I leave it to your lordship's choice. And I resume the seat. Judgment is yet to be pronounced. We don't know what's going to happen. But I tell you, the suffocation or the assault of an ego, all this did not happen. They were extremely comfortable in hearing this statement. Right? Now the experience I need to share, that's more important to me because there are a few youngsters here. Many a times, ideas don't come to your mind through your human effort. Now, how did this come? My senior is in Chennai, a few thousand kilometers away. I am sitting in Bombay and I am praying to him, how does this occur? The answer is this. When we speak, dial a number sitting in this room to somebody in the US, he or she is able to pick up the call because there is a telecommunication network which transfers the... You enter into a court, you show an access card, and then it's able to find out amongst thousands of advocates whether you are a right advocate, you have registered in this, and then it allows you to enter. That's in all your offices, everywhere. So what a machine can do, God, the creator of all these machines, can do it much better. Much better. Now, what he can do for you, all that he requires is, when you pray, he has his own access card to test. The only test he applies every time in your life is, are you a worthy disciple of your guru, of your master? Without mother's love and guru's blessings, a man will end up like a brat. He is only an animal. These are two unique creatures in God's wisdom and God's kingdom. Why? Our scriptures say, what is so unique between a mother and a guru? They know only to give love, without anything in expectation in return. And more than that, both of them do not have the power to curse. They can't curse their children, nor curse their shishyas or devotees. And therefore, these two human forms are celebrated and said you should worship these two forms in your life. So, this is exactly, more than law, let's understand, go back to your roots. Be a worthy shishya of your guru. God will guide you to guru without any difficulty. Have no doubts about it. Substitute your ego with God's help. Keep seeking his help. Any number of times he will help you, subject to this verification. Every time he will verify, are you a worthy shishya of your guru? And have you disrespected your mother? These two tests, double test, you have to pass every time. So never abuse your mother, never abuse your teacher. Whether it's a school teacher or a drawing teacher or a sports teacher or your professional guru. Never abuse. So, sorry for the digression. I always mix law and ethics to the best of our ability, because we build our land produces such invaluable treasure, and therefore it's our duty also to pass that treasure along with law. Especially in public forums. So, this is how we dissected, when does a transfer of right use take place as a sale, when does it limit itself as a pure service?
Sir, can I intervene?
Yeah, sure.
I don't have an authority or something, locus standi to contravene you or to argue against you.
No, you have authority.
Particularly, when 29 AD we are looking at, a tax on transfer of right to use, it never talks about exclusive right to use.
Now, good.
So, how would you differentiate thing?
No, I see.
Particularly, if we are looking for a Tata Sons judgment, when the use of the logo Tata is there, that right to use have been absolute. The receiver of the right uses it at his own will.
Correct.
And that right can be used by so many other people also.
Simultaneously.
Which have been
so, used. Answer is this.
So, why this exclusiveness?
I understand. Now, see, this was raised by the learned judges. Where do you find the expression exclusive? How are you reading it into the constitution? We said we are not reading anything. We don't have to read anything. We have to read something which is written. What is written? It says a tax on the transfer of right to use goods. Now you remove the word transfer and read the constitution. A tax on the right to use goods. Now, constitution has used a prefix, transfer of a right to use, and not a mere right to use. So, transfer means loss. We cited Salman jurisprudence, we cited so many things. Transfer means loss of right in your hands and embedment of the right in somebody else's hands. Exclusive is part of that transfer. How can you retain a right after transferring? You can't have both. Either you transfer or you don't transfer. So the difference in the constitution is, it is not a tax on the right to use. If you see income tax, royalty clause, there again, transfer it, right, subclause 4A says right to use, but subject to transfer. That is why Clause Ogle, all classical authors have said, delivery and control and possession should inure to the other man. Otherwise, you can't impose a royalty under the Income Tax Act. Settle law, Dell judgment, myself and Prabodh, we were the first to deliver, get the judgment in the country, as far as this position is concerned. And that rules even today. Madras High Court did not agree with the judgment, but Delhi High Court said Madras High Court is wrong. Even the recent Shinho Sarli judgment. So that looks to be the law. So, if you don't use the word transfer, what you say is right. Mere licensing, keep on giving it. Exclusive, non-exclusive, doesn't matter. But because you use the expression transfer, it becomes exclusive.
Then why VAT or CEDEX is leviable on transfer of particularly the softwares?
Now,
Both levies.
No. This dual levy is happening in various industries, including in software. Unfortunately, because there is no, in spite of we getting a judgment in Infosys, you see Infosys judgment of Karnataka High Court, it takes 7 situations and decides tick box. You can read the judgment, it's a 95 page judgment. In fact, former Solicitor General of India Gopal Subramaniam appeared for the Karnataka government, and I appeared for the party. He made me weep, cry, crawl for 2 days before surrendering the fund. It was such a match. 2 days, I had to cry for success, bleed. And finally he conceded, I think he has to win. And therefore the judge started dictating the judgment in my favor. So there, 7 categories have been classified, which is works contract, which is sale contract, which is service contract. This speech, as I deliver, you hear, then it is a service. Because there is no transfer of goods in a medium. Now, Bishan records it. Then, as you go out, instantaneously it is converted into a CD. And he sells each CD, say, at 250 rupees. Then the very same speech, put in a media and sold to you as chattel, liable to sales tax. Same speech. American judgment, referred in 5 judgments in TCS. So, this is how, when does it become sale, when does it become service? It becomes sale when IPR hits a media and put in a tangible form of exchange. It doesn't hit a media, then it remains in the realm of service. A download, that's why, like see, you may say, here is a media, I'm hearing your speech, I'm depositing your speech, and therefore why not I call it transfer of property? They say, it is not a media of a transferable form. As it goes, it also dilutes. it has no power to retain. It goes and it goes out. And therefore, don't call. And now, therefore, following this year formula, Union of India says a download of a software is a service. Whereas the same software put in a CD and transferred to you for the same price is a sale. Now you are paying both taxes because judgments have not been decided. So, it can't be both. Because BSNL has said a transaction can either be sale or it can be service. It can't be both. It's fact. Either I sell or I do service. You may do a composite work of a building contract or a car repair contract. That's a works contract. That's a works contract. That's different. So, this is how we decided a transfer right to use.
Just one more point.
Sure.
The first poser which we have given, that TV channel rights of a particular program, it will definitely be transformed into some CD or some media.
Right.
And if that has been given to somebody else for user for say 2 years.
Answer is this. if you have transferred your channel, your copyright to a particular channel exclusively.
Not exclusively.
1 minute. If you have done it, then go and pay sales tax. If you retain the right and give only the channel the right to telecast, saying that I give you, once you telecast is over, I have the right to give it to somebody else. You retain the right with you, then the transfer is only, the use is only a service.
What if exclusiveness is for a territory?
No, even, yeah, good. See, even if it is exclusive for a territory, you still have the retain the right to give it exclusive or non-exclusive elsewhere. Exclusive, the loss of right should be absolute for a temporary period. You must not have a control over it, sir.
But looking to that same theory of media, if it is converted into media and then media have been given,
then it becomes chattel. See, it's like this. I write a book, say for 1,000 pages. I retain the copyright with me. Then I give you the right to publish for this area. 1,000 copies you print and give. Retain the right. It is a service. But 1,000 copies of books which he has printed and sold are goods. They are chattel. The Microsoft Windows, I give the software to you to replicate. That right is a license right or a transfer right to use right, we can debate. But somebody replicates 1 million copies out of it and sells, that is chattel. Okay. Don't worry about that. There is no transfer right.
So there is a distinction between these and
that. Clear?
I just have a question. Even when we say that absolute transfer, a copyright is never absolutely transferred.
Yes. There are three cases. Good question raised. Now, you can do it in three forms. An absolute transfer where you lose your right permanently, it becomes sale simpliciter. A temporary loss of right for a few months or a few years is a transfer of right to use, therefore still a sale. A retention of the right and giving you the leasehold rights or the license right for a limited period is only a service. What's the point? It's very, there is enough light already thrown, which I will put the light in the right direction. What they mean by control is loss of right in your hands and gain of that very same right in the hands of the other. After the transfer, you have nothing left out in your hands to meddle with it. Then control has passed. If you keep meddling with it, then you are retaining control. You can't say, I will meddle with it and I still pass control. Not possible.
Now, what about restrictive conditions?
See, restrictive conditions, it's like this. You own and put restrictive conditions, you retain the control and put restrictive conditions, service. You divest the control and still put restrictive condition. You can use it only this time. You can use it only this many hours. All that. Then it will be still sale. Restrictive condition has nothing to do with control.
No, but if the conditions are not fulfilled, the control will... lose the right to control.
It's a conditional control, but still control at the moment is lost as long as he complies with the control. You can have restrictions. Still control is lost. As long as he obeys, he fulfills the contractual obligations. That's the point.
So how to distinguish a permanent and a temporary control?
Simple. Permanent control, you will weep forever. Temporary control, you weep for a temporary period.
Say for 39 years or 40 years or 45 years.
Yeah. See, in a Transfer of Property Act, all these amendments are coming. All these are now construed to be nothing but. But in Sales Tax Act, it doesn't make a difference whether it's a 99 years lease or a 49 years lease. As long as he's going to pay consideration, you have to pay sales tax. They are very clear. There is no deeming fiction. Beyond this period, a lease transaction becomes a sales simpliciter. There is no law in sales tax as of now. They are not concerned because they are taxing both. They need not have to do it. Okay. Now we'll come to the hotel. Yeah, anything?
Which is that judgment which is reserved?
Monsanto's case. See, this IPRC, BT cotton. BT cotton. We have argued that it's only a license because the control is not handed over. The license is kept on, they keep on issuing the licenses to as many users as possible. And therefore, you should tax it only as a service, like Tata & Sons. Where Tata & Sons owned the bank and it gave only licensed rights. It never lost its right at any point of time. And this distinction was not brought out before the court. That's what we said. We said it's not an error in judgment. It's an error in argument. Even if a judge errs, he will only say there's an error in argument. That's most important. Because a judge like God can never be wrong. That's the first. He's like a boss, the management principle. Boss is never wrong. First principle. Second principle. If he is wrong, follow rule one. Boss is always right. So, right. Now, if you come to the portal, this is what portal says. There again, with all humility, I say I am the only counsel who has succeeded the matter in Kerala High Court. All other five judgments of the five court, High Courts are against SSC. Kerala versus five. That's all pending in Supreme Court. Now, what is the issue? Now, in a works contract, you have material separate and service separate. Right? You can tax it. Material for the material portion, sales tax, service for the service tax. Both. Now, some question has been asked, I'll answer that finally. In food contract, you can't dissect it that way. Even though it involves idlis. Why? 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 Because three judgments of the Supreme Court prior to 46th Amendment has deemed the entire transaction to be service. They didn't say one portion is service, another portion is sale, like guarantor credit. Now, what did 46th Amendment do at that point of time? There was no service tax. It deemed the entire service to be sale. So, 100 rupees is a sale, including the butler's nice protruding hat, the beautiful cutlery, the beautiful linen, the music, or something beyond that. Everything is a package. Now, what happened in Supreme Court was this. Five judges in Damodar Swami Naidu's case, five, constitutional bench, has held the whole transaction is only a sale. Two judges later in Tamil Nadu Kalyana Mandapam's case, where they were deciding a catering service, not a restaurant service, somewhere has said you can split the contract under Clause B and Clause F. Both works contract and food contract can be split into two and you can tax it as sale and service by the respective governments. So you have a five judge, you have a two judge. And the five judgment was referred to in the two, but two did not deal with it. It only refers it. This argument is referred. Argument is not addressed. So you have two Supreme Court judgments opposed to each other. And the two judgment is later in time. So what do you do? So government issued this notification service tax on the strength of these two judgments. Tamil Nadu Kalyana Mandapam said you can break the contract, we are breaking the contract, pay 60%. That's the law. Now, so one more research, wonderful research. What is the research? You have a five-member count, because the law of the Supreme Court is, if there are conflicting views, then the later view should prevail. But here, the earlier view is by a constitutional bench, five. Later view is a division bench, two. So will this formula apply, later will prevail? Do research. We discovered this rule will not apply. The second judgment is actually per incurium, the quasi-constitutional bench judgment. The later in time will come only when the judgment is of equal strength. See, law is a fascinating subject. It's a pleasure to do law. Any fellow will say that, engineer will say, doctor will say, it's a pleasure to do surgery. The fellow is dying on the table. So the client who is sponsoring our case, oh my God, what pleasure. Get me my stay, man. It is a heart attack every day, sir. Oh my God. That is, the work is so pressurizing and the disconnect is widening. And abuse is alarmingly on the increase. You have wonderful litigation, but quantum of relief you can get is, oh my God. This is the scenario today in Indian judiciary. The disconnect is so huge and wide. Especially revenue matters. Criminal matter and revenue matter, the law says the presumption should be in favor of the assessee and in favor of the accused. But in practice, the presumption is against the assessee and against the accused. When you stand up for a bail, the judge only sees the public prosecutor. Can we grant him bail? No, my lord. No, bail is rejected. Changing times. So, now, therefore, we argued, ignore the subsequent judgment, follow constitutional bench. Kerala High Court followed it. And it said, in a food contract, you can impose only a sales tax, you can't impose service tax. Whereas Bombay, Allahabad, Chhattisgarh, Chennai, all of them have said, you can impose both the taxes. In spite of BSNL, Supreme Court, which says you can't impose both taxes.
BSNL 2006 also allows splitting.
No. In the case of works, see, it says that was not the case before BSNL was transfer right use. Okay? Not a case of food. So, that's what they are relying in Tamil Nadu. Two are relying on three. Again, that three has not considered a Dhammaswami Naidu. That was a case on food itself. So, even though he's absolutely right. Remarkable. It's a pleasure to argue, pleasure to address Chartered Accountants. I bowed up. The quality, your quality is certainly far superior. I have addressed several institutes. It's a pleasure to address a Chartered Accountant gathering. That's nice. Now, the point is this. Even though an arbiter of a Supreme Court is binding, if the arbiter is contrary to a ratio of a constitutional bench, it's not binding. Not binding. The constitutional bench has said, it is only a food contract. It's only a sale contract. That's the law. Whatever may happen after that. So, splitting is incorrect. They are all holding their foot into it because of BSNL and the Tamil Nadu Velanadu case. Nothing else. Nothing else. It is wrong, actually. And all these matters are now before the Delhi High Court. It came 2 weeks before. And vociferously, the ASG said, covered by Bombay, covered by Justice, covered by... Well, I am covered by one constitutional bench judgment of the Supreme Court. You can decide whether High Court is bigger or Supreme Court is bigger. Matter adjourned. Because they said we'll hear you on it, because there's time constraint. It's a great bench. So matter got adjourned. So these are all...
Yeah, only one... sort of thing. This 29A amendment or 4th amendment, 46th amendment, it's a dimming fiction sort
Pramod, of. Pramod, it's 720. Wrong time? Flight is delayed? Very good. Both same time?
No,
9. We'll go together.
So it is a dimming fiction. So dog has been said to be a man. Something for which
Which law say dog is man? I want to know. If man is dog, it's acceptable. You are bringing a new law, I want to know.
So dog is said to be a man.
Yeah.
So something...
No, Nitin prompts me to say, women are joyous in clapping more. But you must understand, under the law, man includes women. Good.
Doesn't it mean that if the taxes can be levied, if it is a deeming fiction, by deeming fiction, if something which is not sale is considered to be a sale, then by its natural course it is a services. So service tax and sales tax.
It's not natural.
Can it be concurrently be applied?
No, it can't. Good question. See, he says the natural domain before three Supreme Court judgment has said it is service. Now 46th amendment says it is sale. So today it is service prior to amendment, sale after amendment, therefore you will tax both. No, you have converted your service as deemed to be sale. You have robbed it out of the pocket of service and put it in